Hey guys, I'm Rob. I'm a professional engineer by examination, profession, and education, in structural engineering. I'm here today to explain in 5 easy steps how to pass the PE exam. When I was studying for the exam myself, I took it back in April 2016. I noticed when I read the blogs and ran across different YouTube videos that they would recommend, you know, to read this reference manual cover to cover, do 500 or so practice problems, and you'll be set. And while it's not necessarily bad advice, it's not really realistic with the time constraints. If you have a full-time job, if you have a family, whatever have you, whatever your situation is. So I wanted to make a video to explain the steps I used to maximize my time and to have a more realistic goal. Most people I know, including myself, don't have a photographic memory. So reading a reference manual cover to cover does you no good. You don't remember what you read in chapter 1 when you get to chapter 20. So, that being said, hope you like these steps and let me know. Okay, step 1, register for the exam. I can't tell you how many times I've talked to people, whether it's coworkers or former classmates, where they're ignorant about the registration deadlines and what's required for NCEES, which is the governing body for the exam, and your state boards. So make sure you register for the exam. Down below, I've put a link to NCEES where you can find the information for the actual examination and the deadlines associated with them in that organization. And also down below, I've put in a link for each state board examination. So go down, find your state, and click on the link and find out what they require for you to take the exam and register. And remember, in more states, so now, there's a difference between registering for the exam and applying for a license. So make sure you know the difference and what you need for each process. That's very important. Okay, step 2, and this is probably the most important step that I felt personally, prepare a study schedule. Make it realistic, put in family vacations, put in job responsibilities, whatever, you know, if you're traveling for work a certain day, will you be able to study that day? Make a schedule, put in how many hours you think you'll be able to study that day. And next to those hours, put in what you're going to study. So let's say I'm going to study on Tuesday. Say I'm going to study Tuesday for 2 hours on reinforced concrete beams. That way you hold yourself to a strict schedule. You know, if you fall behind, it's tangible. You can see if you fall behind in your studies. I can't stress that enough. You need to be able to see these things. You know, it's better a visual representation. If you have a schedule, you can see if you're behind in your studies. You can also see if the schedule you made is not realistic. You know, in probably a week or two, you can tell, oh man, I put way too much in this schedule. I can't keep this. I have to revise. Or you can say, oh, I put way too little. I'm, you know, flying through the schedule. Maybe I can get in some extra problems or so, you know, in week 5 or something like that. So make a study schedule. I've also put down below an example of a schedule I made personally for the PE exam, and it helped me tremendously. When I was step 3, obtain all required references that NCEES outlines in their specs for whatever test you plan on taking, whatever depth you plan to take. I can't stress this enough as well. Don't come in there and think you can pass if you're missing a reference manual that they say you need to pass the exam. You don't want to miss out on a question or two just because you left the required text at home. That question or two might be what you need to pass the exam. You never know. So bring all required references that they list. If you remember, in step 1, the link is below, and you can go on the website and pick your depth that you plan to take, whether it's transportation, structural, you know, water resources, and they'll outline what references they say to bring. Also, I would say pick you up a copy of the Civil Engineering Reference Manual. This was invaluable. Can't stress that enough. It was invaluable. Pick it up, go through it. If you see, I have it tabbed. basically, throughout the whole entire morning section, I used this reference. It helped me. It was a true lifesaver. It was easy to use. One thing I will say is tab the index. You can go on PPI's website, and they have a PDF of the index for this manual. Print it out, tab it, and keep that separate in your, you know, in your binder or whatever. That way, it's easier to flip through a, 10 sheets than to go through this, 1,000-page manual and go to the back of the book and flip it through that. So make sure you pick up that CERM. I call it the CERM, C-E-R-M. You can pick it up off of PPI, Amazon, eBay, ask around. Different colleagues probably have this book who've passed the exam. It's a lifesaver. Remember to tab this book. Tab it. Tab all your resources. And make sure the tabs are meaningful, that you know what they are, and use them a lot, because they will help you out to find answers fast. Step four to passing the P exam is to pick up some practice problems, and in particular, pick up the NCEES practice exam for the particular exam that you plan to take. That practice exam was pretty good. I also went to PPI. They have a practice exam for the PE exam on their website. I put a link down below to PPI. That helped me tremendously, but use those practice exams. In particular, the NCEES practice exam had the most realistic questions. You'll come across a lot of practice problems that may take you, 10 to 15 minutes to do, even if you know every step by heart. In reality, you only have on average 6 minutes per problem. So you know that if a problem is too hard, if it has too many steps, it's not realistic. Don't waste your time doing those extremely long problems. Break those out, into smaller sets. If it's a part of the problem that you're not really comfortable with, do that part of the problem. Don't do the whole thing. And again, that saved me a lot of time. In my first 2 or 3 weeks of studying, I was going through, these 30-minute problems, especially for the areas I wasn't even doing the depth in, and it was sucking up a lot of my time. So I went back and revised how I was doing that, and I only chose problems that were pretty similar to difficulty that I saw in NCEES, and that helped me out a lot. I got through a lot more problems. My time is used a lot more wisely. And okay, step five is another important step. If step two, creating the study schedule, was the most important for me, step five was, 1B. It was just as almost equally as important, is create flow charts. I personally took the structural depth, and creating flow charts for the depth section on how to solve certain types of problems sped up my time dramatically. I was able to solve problems a lot faster because I had the steps outlined, and by outlining steps, I didn't have to remember. I didn't have to sit there and act like I was Einstein to figure out these problems. I wrote it down. I had it saved, so when I came across a problem that was similar, I had the steps and I could just review it quickly. I knew exactly where to go in my CERN manual or my reference manual. And again, I had it tabbed out, so it was easy to flip to the page and answer the question. Creating flowcharts. And again, I know this is kind of repetitive, but down below, I put a sweatpants. Excuse the sweat marks. I know this is repetitive, but down below, I put an example of a flowchart I used to solve a problem. So use that to guide you. And, comment, share a like if you want to see more of the flowcharts I use. I saved just a lot of them. I should say not all of them, a lot of them. I'd be willing to share. You don't have to pay me. This is free advice. Okay, guys and girls, that advice kind of concluded, the tips I used to pass the PE exam. And again, this is just five easy tips. I didn't go real in depth into these tips. I didn't need to. They're pretty simple to use. on average, I shouldn't say on average, but in total, I think I studied about 150 hours, maybe 100 to 150. I didn't, you know, study the, you know, 300 hours that you sometimes read. I'm not a genius. I don't have a master's degree in structural engineering. You know, I'm just an average Joe, average Rob, who took the exam, you know, made the study schedule, revised it when needed, tabbed my references, and created flow charts, and knew, you know, when I need to sign up for the exam and what I need to bring to the exam. You know, I use these steps, they're invaluable, and I hope these helped you. If you liked what you saw, post a like, post a comment. I like to talk to people about this stuff, and be on the lookout for my next video. Usually I do car videos, so be on the lookout for those. Thanks.